I got a phone call from the masjid, and they said, Akhi, are you around? And there was a conference going on in the masjid at the time. And this brother had been found outside, and he was trying to strangle himself. This young brother, he is approximately 14 years old. Subhanallah, this brother with his own two hands was trying to strangle himself to death. And alhamdulillah, the security and the volunteers from the masjid, they managed to stop the brother and he passed out. So he was carried into the masjid reception, away from, you know, the general public. One of the shuyukh was reciting over him at the time, Ikhwani, but the sheikh's lecture now, it was next, and he said, look, you need to take over. So I took over and I continued with the recitation, and subhanallah, all of a sudden, this brother, he was lying down on the floor, back on the floor, and he just got up, he sprung up with, you know, a lot of force. And the jinn said, I'm going to kill him. I'm going to kill him. This was the first thing that came out of the mouth of this boy. And the voice wasn't the normal voice of a boy. It was a very croaky, very deep voice. And the voice said, I'm going to kill him. And so I said, what are you going to kill him for? What's the problem? Why are you going to kill this 14-year-old child? And the jinn told us, this boy killed my children. So what do you mean he killed your children? And the jinn said, well, he stepped on my kids. He stepped on my kids. And I thought, okay, subhanAllah. Now we have the reason why this brother is trying to strangle himself to death. This is the reason why he's trying, it seems like he's trying to end his own life. Ikhwani, subhanAllah. SubhanAllah. What's happened is, this brother was going somewhere and he's killed the children of this jinn, and now the jinn wants revenge. So I said to this jinn, I said, ya jinni, are you a Muslim? Are you a Muslim? And the jinn said, yes, I'm a Muslim. Yes, I'm a Muslim. Because I thought, subhanAllah, we're in a masjid right now. We're in a masjid right now, there's angels around us, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. You know, we are surrounded with the mercy of Allah. There is dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembrance of Allah going on. It's very unlikely that this jinn is going to be able to even enter into the masjid if it's a non-Muslim jinn. So I said to the jinn, ya jinni, are you Muslim? And the jinn said, yes, I'm a Muslim. So then I reminded the jinn about Yawm al-Qiyamah. I said to the jinn, you have no right to be in this person. You have no right to be trying to take his life. He is the slave of Allah. What are you going to say to Allah? Who will defend you on Yawm al-Qiyamah? Who is going to defend you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment? The day on which your wealth and your children are not going to benefit you. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, alhamdulillah, the jinn screamed and the boy's body, it lifted up. And then it dropped back down and the jinn left. And the jinn left, and the jinn, to the best of my knowledge, hasn't returned since then. Walhamdulillah. The boy's friends were around. They made me aware that this boy, on his way home, he takes a shortcut through the park. And so, he doesn't walk through the park, he runs through the park, and sometimes it's after Maghrib, sometimes it's late at night. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but what it seems, what happened was, this boy was running home through the park one night, and he stepped on one of the jinni's children, and he killed them, or a group of them, and he killed them. And so the jinn wanted revenge for that. And that's how he killed the children of the jinn. One of the lessons, Ikhwani, is a practical lesson for each and every single one of us. Don't just be throwing things across the room in your house. Don't just be, you know, acting in this way, because you don't know. This is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we simply cannot see. So if we can't see them, then we have to be very careful. So if you need to throw something, say Bismillah. Make this announcement that, look, I'm going to throw something. Say Bismillah before you throw it across the room. Say Bismillah before you throw it down the stairs. Say Bismillah. Mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and inshaAllah, this will protect you. Another point of benefit, Ikhwani, for those people who might potentially be doing ruqya. When you come across a jinn that is Muslim, I found that it's a lot easier to bargain with them, to remind them, and to get them to leave with the permission of Allah. Why? Because they are Muslim. So if you ever come across a Muslim jinn, tell him to fear Allah. Tell him to remember Yawm al-Qiyamah. Remind him that he is going to die. And inshaAllah, you will find that they are a lot easier to deal with than the non-Muslim jinn.